I got an email from a listener who identifies himself only as B1 Away, who thanked me for pointing him in the direction of the internet translator site where one can type in something in English and have it translated into various foreign gibberish, and he uses it in an interesting way. He explains that he leaves notes in Spanish for the girl he's sweet on, but adds that she is not a Spanish-speaking person. He says it makes it easier to say the mushy and personal things he wishes to say to her, but which are too intimate to say face-to-face. And I sympathize with B1 Away because even though the Oxford English Dictionary fills 20 volumes, representing 21,000 pages, describing more than 600,000 words and phrases, illustrated by more than 2,400,000 quotations, it is hard to choose the right ones when one is trying to express one's feelings in an affair of the heart. The average high school graduate has a vocabulary of 60,000 words, of which most everyday conversation is comprised of perhaps 3,000, not including nacho-licious and choco-sational. But the technique of translating one's deepest, visceral sentiments into a language foreign to the recipient of one's ardor would seem to me unique in the annals of romance. And this is another fine example of the internet being used as a means of communications avoidance. Much of what is communicated across the internet is miscommunication. A recent email I received claims more people are killed annually by donkeys than die in airplane crashes. Where does one confirm such a statistic? And another writer says the rule of thumb originated in a decision by a British court that a husband could beat his wife with a stick if it were no thicker than his thumb, which is another statement which I imagine would wither under the heat lamp of careful scrutiny. And the latest internet urban legend it is our participle dangling duty to disabuse you of is that the Alabama legislature passed a bill redefining the mathematical value of pi. This internet email, which has circumnavigated the circumference of the globe, purports the intelligence that NASA engineers in Huntsville are upset that the state legislature has changed the official value of pi from 3.14 to an even 3. And the story goes that Alabama Governor Guy Hunt will sign the bill, which was sponsored by State Representative Leonard Lee Lawson. And it turns out that Guy Hunt hasn't been governor of Alabama since 1993, and there is no Representative Lawson. And the math department at the University of Alabama was relayed the email from Purdue University, which got it from a Yale University posting, and Yale received it from a scientific organization in Hawaii, which doesn't know where it first saw it. So the ratio of the circumference to the diameter of a circle will continue to be expressed as 3.14159. etc., and so forth ad infinitum. And nowhere in my email does it explain why the legislature of Alabama would wish to change pi to an even 3, although it would absolve me of the obligation to report when some pi-ciphering pencil neck busies a phalanx of Cray supercomputers to spread it out another 2.5 million digits. Because in mathematical terms, 3.14 is just pi's nickname, while its full name is unknown, and mathematicians continue to guess at it like Rumpelstiltskin. As an individual who spends less time contemplating the ratio of the circumference to the diameter in a circle as I do consulting the TV guide, I'll just call it 3 for short. As the writer Harvey Carter expressed it, 'tis a favorite project of mine, a new value of pi to assign. I would fix it at 3, for it's simpler, you see, than 3.14159, because pi is Greek to me. By which, I do not mean that pi is the 16th letter of the Greek alphabet, which it indisputably is, but rather that generally, the only time I encounter the letters pi is when they're preceded by magnum.